Hey folks, Mike and McGee here. In today's video, we're going to take two skipjack herrings that these guys caught. Caleb here actually caught this one. It's the biggest.
17 inches.
17 inches.
That's one David's.
David caught this 15. One. 15. So you win.
Yeah.
Now, this is highly known as catfish candy, and we're getting ready to go on our houseboat adventure catching catfish. So one thing I've learned here recently, there are some bait companies that take shad and they salt cure. They basically brine the shad so they don't rot while they're on the hook. And that's the biggest issue with a bait fish, is they rot while you're looking at them. It's unbelievable. So what I'm gonna do in today's video, I'm gonna cut these up just like what we're gonna use when we put them on the hook. And I'm gonna put them in my salt brine, because let's face it, we're done making bacon for the year. And I've got a lot of salt that still has a lot of curing potential. So I'm gonna cut these up right quick and do that. I think these things are gonna bleed like stuck hogs. I can't show blood on YouTube, so we're just gonna see what happens. Needless to say, if you don't see me cut them up, it's probably because they bled like stuck hogs. I'm gonna grab my knife here. So if you put it right here and you just rock it back and forth, that's what Longbow told me to do. And now we're already getting into some blood. We're gonna just rock it back and forth. And I can see that that's all you get to see. I'm so sorry. I would love to show it all, but I can't. All right, here's the cut pieces. You can see just beautiful pink meat. I washed each piece individually and washed the table down good. It was a bloodbath you just wouldn't believe. And of course, the catfish probably would do better if it was bloody. But in my opinion, the salt's going to pull all that out anyway. This experiment does not include blood. This is the first time we've ever done this. We've always put it on the line just like this and bloody. So this is going to be an experiment. Let's get it in this salt and we're going to cure it for just about 2 days. Pull them in like that. Just pile them in here. So now just going to coat it really good. Cover them completely over just like this. Just like curing a ham. It's gonna be very interesting to see if this works. And it's also interesting to see if the fish will bite it. All right, it's been about 2.5 days since we salted this catfish candy. I'm gonna pull some of it out. I really don't know if I should wash it off or not. I'm definitely gonna package it and save it. I'm really happy about how the scales stayed on and they're still quite shiny, because that shine, that glimmer is somewhat what attracts the fish. So, oh boy, this is interesting, very interesting. Now, fish don't always bite, as we found out today. Because I took the boys fishing today and we caught a bunch of minnows, and we couldn't get a single bite, let alone catch a fish. We couldn't catch a single stripe, a single skipjack. We got zilch. So I'm actually left with a lot of minnows. I'm gonna take the minnows and I'm gonna put them in this salt and I'm gonna cure them. And we're gonna also take them to the lake and see how they do. But the next scene you're gonna see, and we're gonna be on the lake baiting lines. All right, folks, we're at the lake. We've got our salted minnows and our big chunks of salted skipjack herring. That's what we're gonna use next. But right now we're gonna use these little ones. As you can see, they're still covered in salt, but when the salt washes off, they're shiny. They feel tough. I don't know if they're gonna last a long time on the hook or not. We got all different sizes. We got big ones and little ones both. Right up here by the shore is where they bite the best. Give me a bigger one, that's a pretty big hook. Very tough. I believe he'll stay on the hook a lot longer than a fresh one. Let's just hope they like them. Because if we come checking in the morning and there ain't no fish on and all the bait's still hanging on, that's a little depressing, you know? we don't get it out of here, we're gonna be messing with it the whole time.
And the miracle whip.
All right, time to eat. Having catfish sandwiches. Smoked catfish sandwiches, ain't it? Is it good, Matt? Really fine?
Yep.
Dave? Mmm. All right, this is the line we're gonna do the skipjack. This is the skipjack that David and Caleb caught on our river adventure recently. And that right there is a tail. Let's get the salt off. Look at that, shiny. Wow, I don't know if it shows up in the camera, but that is just as shiny as it was the day we caught it. That's incredible. I highly expect that we're gonna catch a fish right here by this rock. So I'm gonna go ahead and bait this entire line with skipjack. Next is a big head. And if we catch anything, you, my friends, will be the first to see it. I just felt the fish get on. And I'm trying to figure out which way. Is it behind us where the bait is or ahead? Nope, it's up here on a bare hook. There ain't no telling what we just caught on a bare hook. Let's go find it, boys. Caleb, you want to dig out the dip net? We might have us a big old monster hook fish. I have no idea. This don't happen often, folks. He might have a little snagged his little self, but he may have bit it. Shiny hook like that. But it's definitely pulling good. I mean, we've only put like 3 or 4 baits on this line, and all of a sudden I start feeling the kaboom, boom, 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 boom. I hope he don't get off, because if he did snag himself, he might not be hooked very well. But he's still on. He must be plumbed out the other end. He might be pretty big if he's at the other end making it feel that good. Can anybody see him?
Yep. Yep, I seen it. I seen it.
What was it?
I couldn't tell.
When you're catching fish, when you're catching fish on bare hooks, it could be anything.
Should I get in front of you or stay back here?
I think it's snagging.
He's
a catfish.
It is a catfish. This is the first fish of the trip, folks. Caught on a bare hook. No, he didn't snag himself. He bit that thing. He bit a bare hook, folks. Right in the mouth. How do you like them apples? He bit a bare hook. If that's any indication of how the week's gonna go, I'm pretty excited. Joe, I'm gonna let you put him on the ice. Careful, Caleb, he gonna wiggle. He gonna wiggle. All right, we are at the first line. Now, this is the next morning. We are at the first line, and this is the salt cured minnows. Joe, do you feel anything yet?
Yep, there's a fish on.
Oh my goodness. We got a fish on. Fish on. Oh, oh. Oh, it's a good one. It's a good one. It's a good one, boys. Oh man, okay, there's your answer. Salt cured minnows work. And here's another answer. Something ate the body off of this one, but the head's still good. Technically, you could still catch catfish with that head. Oh, look at that. Take a look at that minnow, see if it still looks good. Is it still fresh or does it like stinky? Smell it. Still smells good. Okay, that was the whole point of this whole thing, is to keep our bait good on the line. Because when it rots, they won't eat it. And we have a lot of experience taking off rotten, stinky bait. All right, here is the next one. We've got it tied to the rock right there. We're just gonna, let me get a hold of that line.
There you see right there, the bait's still good. All right, Matt's gonna do the pulling. David's gonna help, and Joel will be dip netting for a while here anyway. Look at that big bait, and it's still just as fresh as it was the day we put it out yesterday. Somebody moved in on us. We're hoping that they ain't thieves. It's kind of hard to hide what we're doing right now. Yeah. Oh, is it a good one, Matt? Looks like a good one. Oh, man, yeah. My goodness, yes. Oh, can you get him past you without him getting away, reckon? Oh, yeah, all right. Here we go. Good job, Joe. Good job, Joe. There's a big old dark male channel catfish right there. Oh man, that's gonna be good on that grill. We're gonna be grilling him up for the friends and the family. Hey, that come out pretty easy. Yeah. All right, Caleb, open the ice chest. Boy, it's one of them big dark males. Get it wide. He's a strong one. Watch him, Joe, he's a strong one. He's one of them boogers. Oh yeah, boy, he's toughy. He's a toughy. Oh man, look how dark he is. Goodness. All right, keep us a rolling there, Matt. I'm gonna turn this motor a little bit, help you out. Hopefully whatever it was didn't get tangled up and get away. Mm-hmm. See them bubbles? That's where the wood you're on. Yeah, I think so. I think that's what happened, just ripped it right off, but that's better than getting tangled up where you can't get loose. You hung up again?
No, there's a fish
on here,
I think.
Okay. All right, fish on. There he is, I see color down in there. Just a decent sized channel catfish. Good going, boys. Good going. Nice fish, Joe. All right, good going.
All right, now that we know that cured baits work, we had Mr. Caleb last night catching bluegill wide open. He caught quite a few of them. And of course, we knew they were gonna rot by morning if we just left them in the water because they run out of oxygen in your bucket and die. And so instead of doing that, I packed them boogers in salt. And here we go. That right there is a cured bluegill head. And as you see, once the salt's washed off, very good looking bait. So I'm just gonna go through and I'm gonna rebait this line with the bluegill bait that is cured with salt. It's not gonna go bad in this water, even though we're having pretty warm days. Look at the sun just popping over the hill on my face. So there you go, folks. This video was about cured baits. Do they work? We know they work now, and we know that after sitting in that warm water overnight, they still didn't spoil, which that's what we figured would happen. We just didn't know if the fish would like them. And if you have any other questions about this method, just let me know in the comments. Salt didn't cost us a thing because it was leftover used salt from our bacon, ham, etc. Speaking of salt cured baits, let's try an end cut of Mangalita bacon and see what happens. So we're gonna get on out of here. We hope you have a great day. We'll see you on the next video.